How do you detach yourself from football?
It's something that I've probably learned to do as I've got older. You know, you're surrounded by it so much that inevitably you're going to be taking it in. You're going to watch games and you're going to sort of see coverage. But you know, I've found that I've got other interests as well aside from football. And you know, obviously I've got a family, so you know that's the main priority when I go home. But in my downtime, I kind of prefer to, you know, listen to a bit of music or have a read or you know, something like that really.
Is that your biggest passion, the music side of things?
Yeah, probably. It's something for me to kind of delve into when I've got a bit of time on my hands. And as I say, it's something that's kind of grown on me as well as a you know as I've got a bit older. I've got a bit more into it, and it's just as I say, it's a bit of an escape really from football because, as I said before, it's always around you anyway. And you know, you get to come in and do your work every day and train, and then when I go home, I like to sort of switch off from it as much as I can and relax and do other things.
Everybody knows one song sung blue, every garden grows one. Me and you are subject to the blues now and then, but when you take the blues and make a song, you sing them out again. Sing them out again. Song sung blue, weeping like a willow. Song sung blue, sleeping on my pillow. Funny thing, but you can sing it with a cry in your voice. Before you know it, get to feeling good. You simply got no choice. Subject to the blues now and then, but when you take the blues and make a song, you sing them out again. Song sung blue, weeping like a willow. Song sung blue, sleeping on my pillow. Can sing it with a cry in your voice. And before you know it, start feeling good. You simply got no choice.